Hey friends, so it's no secret that I'm an Arturia fanboy, and they just released Pigments 6. And not only is the new Modal engine one of the coolest new synthesizers, like really ever, there's all these new hidden features that are allowing me to make sounds and music that I've never really made before. And when you combine them with some of the new routing options inside of Ableton, you can make some incredible new stuff. And so check out this idea that I've got going on. Let's go ahead and focus, first of all, on this track right here. Take a listen. Now, this nice little whimsical, fun, percussive sort of idea is actually being generated from a drum kit. Take a listen to this track. I'm going to route this just to the main outs. That's all that that is. Instead, what I'm doing is I'm routing this into this track, Pigments. I'm choosing it as the sidechain input, okay? Now let's go ahead and open Pigments. So right now I'm using the Modal engine, but what I'm doing is I'm using the audio input feature as the exciter. Essentially, the Modal engine has these two different sections here that are called exciters, and they sort of like smack a resonant body, which is this middle part right here, this string part. You can do either string or beam. But using the audio input, we can use a live mic, or we can use a drum track, or we can use anything percussive to trigger the resonating body. So check this out. I'm using a drum beat to trigger this resonating body. And so, of course, I can use all the different features inside of the Modal engine to create just an endless swath of tones. And this is what I'm using to generate my quote-unquote chords from this song, right? And so, I mean, this represents some incredible stuff, right? Some things that I want to show you that might not be immediately obvious and that maybe haven't been covered by other channels yet are two specific things. One thing is that you have two different sides of exciters. Like on this side, this, you know, you can use the audio input, or you can just use like their synthesized like mallets, which is this collision thing, or samples, right? So inside of Ableton, I have this chord progression, right? And so every time I have a note hit, it's going to generate a sound. So let's use like, I don't know, bright or knife. Knife is one of my favorites, right? But in this case, we're using the audio input, but that's not really what I want to show you. What I want to show you though is this side. So you can do all kinds of interesting things over here. This is friction. Essentially, this is just like a noise track. And as I turn up the volume, we can blend both exciters together to create these really interesting sounds. So one of them is friction. Another one that's really cool is the granular one. You know, these could be brought in and out using LFOs that are synced to the clock, right? Let's make this free running. Right? Super cool. So you can use both of these exciter stages to kind of work with each other. So in case you're looking at picking up a copy of Arturia Pigments, folks who join my Pigments online course can get 50% off Pigments and other Arturia software. So if you do the math, you could join the Pigments course and pay less than even how much it normally costs. But it's been a while since I ran a sale, so this week only, you can grab one or all of my Ableton courses at a steep discount, and I'll throw in the Pigments course for free. My Ableton courses contain over 120 hours of hyper-focused video lessons just like this, and are super high-rated to give you everything you need to know to make pro-sounding music at home on your computer. You can also get 30% off Ableton Live software just for enrolling. My channel is sponsored by me, so if you want to support me, consider checking out my courses. Okay, let's get back to it. Another thing I want to show you is that you can unquantize warp. So what does warp do? Essentially, let's just go ahead and look at all these generated partials. You can see that warp is essentially de-emphasizing and emphasizing various different partials that are being generated. But right now, they follow the harmonic overtone series. But if you turn this cue off, what this will do is this will generate some atonal stuff. And man, there are some really interesting sweet spots you can find here. Check this out. And this is also cool if you turn the partials down. With all these partials that are starting to be atonal, this can kind of sound more like a like smacking a big long piece of metal or something, right? It sounds atonal, but when you turn the partials down, see, there's these really fun little sweet spots you can find. And I've found that using lower partials when you're using, when you're taking the warp off quantize is a really good idea. So let's go ahead and return this back to where it was. Tight. Let's look at something else. So Pigments sidechain bus, you can use it all over it. Something else that you can do that's really interesting is this. Check this track out. So let's go ahead and open this Pigments and check this out. Arturia has essentially copied Ableton's vocoder. They're probably gonna get mad at me for saying that, but I mean, look at this. This is kind of all the same options as Ableton's vocoder, except that we have this sibilance feature right here. And then instead of being able to control each individual band, we have a frequency tilt. But something that's really interesting about this is that the modulator can be the audio input. And so of course, you could use that to vocode your voice. Now, in fact, I'll even show you. Let's go ahead and make an audio track. You can see my voice is coming down track three here, and I can send this audio to four Pigments, okay? Yeah, yeah. And so now you can see my voice coming into Pigments here, and if I play a note, but that's not really what is so interesting to me. What's interesting to me is that I can use this as a way to vocode these drums from track one, right? Let's go ahead and listen to this again. So right now I'm using this iridium wavetable, but essentially the drums, you can think of the drums as playing them, right? And so, of course, you can enhance the drums, which will essentially flatline them as they're coming in as a modulator signal. And then sibilance. This is really cool. Take a listen to what happens with this out. We could get punchy sounds here, especially with the frequency tilt up like this. But sibilance says at the bottom, emphasizes the sibilance sounds to improve intelligibility. Well, in this case, we're emphasizing the transients of the drums. And just like Ableton's vocoder, we can gate out lower signals. So much fun to be had, right? Okay, so in the next example, check this out. I've routed the same drums from track one into Pigments, and now, man, this is so cool. They have an envelope follower. So you can take this envelope follower and run it into various features inside of the synth. So let's go ahead and take a listen to this track by itself. And so the way that I've done this is you can choose what the source of the envelope follower is. And so in this case, I've chose audio input. So, I mean, by default, it's set to filter so that whatever you generate with the synth itself, it will be able to create an envelope follower signal for that. But in this case, I'm using, yet again, the audio input here, right? So, and of course, I've added some gain. You can open the release to kind of shape this or make it snappy. And now something else I want to point out. Let's go ahead and get rid of this filter for a second. Take a look at this. So they've also added all pass filters. And a lot of folks are like, you know, what is an all-pass filter, right? Well, essentially all that an all-pass filter does is it flips the phase of whatever signal you're running through it at the point of cutoff. And so in this case, I'm using an all-pass filter 12. Let's switch it over to like 24 or something. And what I've done is I've routed the output of my engine, whatever engine I'm using, to go to both filters at the same time. And then I've changed the routing of those filters to be in parallel. And so what I've essentially created for myself is a phaser. Okay, and but this phaser is really interesting because I can do weird stuff to it, right? So right now it's just kind of going back and forth like a normal phaser would. Take a listen. But you guessed it, I could take this modulation off and then use my envelope follower, for example, to change the phase. I have a lot of effects going on. What do I have here? Let's make this cleaner to hear what the result. Another thing they added is these cluster filters, and man, it is fun to use the peak aspect of them. And something else maybe worth pointing out is this lo-fi filter. Yeah, lots of fun with these filters. All right, so getting back to the jam. I've added an ARP to this using Pigments' inbuilt arpeggiator. Let's take a look at that. I just used the harmonic engine for it, but check this out. Now, what's cool about the arpeggiator and the sequencer is that you can have it regenerate a specified amount of random to each one of the sequencer lanes, or arpeggiator lanes in this case. And so you can see that over time, it's just kind of regenerating a bunch of different things, such as, you know, the octave range or the velocity or the probability, but it's using the same chords from this same riff that I've been using throughout this whole song. So take a listen. So that's really cool. But that's not necessarily a hidden feature, right? What is, though, is that, check this out. So let's say I really like Pigments Arpeggiator. And man, I mean, Pigments Arpeggiator is probably one of the most feature-laden and really, really awesome arpeggiators, as well as the sequencer. What if I want to use that outside of the Pigments ecosystem? Well, check this out. I chose MIDI from, okay, and then six Pigments, and I realized when you normally send MIDI from one track into another, you usually have the choice to choose pre or post. But there's also this Pigments option. What's that all about? Check this out. I discovered that you can actually listen to Pigments sequencer and the arpeggiator and use that output to drive other things. So I decided to use an Ableton wavetable to sort of supplement the arpeggiator, and now we get this. So as you can see, we've got the same notes, the same slides, the same probability, the same velocity, all of that stuff is happening, and it's being exported, if you will. The MIDI of Pigments 6 is being exported into this wavetable track. Just so awesome, right? You can hear how it's different each time. Cool. Well, I hope this video and all the videos that I make are inspiring to you and make you want to crack open your DAW and start making music. If you want to support the channel, the main way that you could do that is check out my courses that I offer on both Pigments and obviously Ableton Live. Thanks for watching, everybody. Like, comment, subscribe. You know what to do. See you next time.